Before we start today's video, we'd like to ask you for your support. To help us bring you videos that sparks curiosity, please support us by becoming a superfan, by clicking the link in the description. So, without further ado, let's begin. Welcome to Lab 360, for all latest happenings from the world of astronomy. Today, we know that almost every star in the night sky has at least one planet, and that a significant portion of those planets are most likely to be rocky planets that orbit their suns at close enough distances to be warm and maybe habitable. Of the million or so years of our existence as a distinct species on Earth, the quest for a habitable world around Proxima Centauri is a natural consequence of the boom in knowledge about exoplanets that humans have attained in just the previous two decades. Whether or not they are livable, if pale red dots are in orbit around Proxima, we are confident we will find them. Proxima Centauri is a small low-mass star, located about 4.25 light-years away from the Sun. It is about 12.5% of the Sun's mass, and its average density is about 33 times that of the Sun. Located in the Centaurus constellation, the Latin name, Proxima Centauri, literally translates to nearest star of Centaurus. It was discovered by Robert Innes in 1915, and is believed to be the star closest to our Sun. By virtue of its low luminosity, Proxima is 500 times less bright than our Sun, and thus cannot be spotted by the naked eye. Yet, it is one of the most noted stars in the sky. This is because it is a part of the Alpha Centauri star system, which hosts three known stars, and is also the closest stellar system to our Sun. Normally, when stars are this close to Earth, they appear bright in the sky. But the reason it is not visible to the naked eye is not only because of its low luminosity, but also its small size. It is called a red dwarf star, and known to have massive solar flares. Astronomers have discovered two planets for Proxima so far. The first, named Proxima B, was discovered in 2016 by the European Southern Observatory, ESO. It is roughly at a distance of 4.7 million miles from Earth, with an orbital period of approximately 11.2 Earth days. Its estimated mass is at least 1.3 times that of the Earth. Interestingly, although Proxima B is declared to be within the habitable zone of its star, a study conducted in 2017 declared that this exoplanet does not share the same atmosphere as Earth. In 2020, a second planet was discovered and named Proxima C. It is much bigger than Earth and orbits its star every 1,907 days. It orbits at about 1.5 times the distance from its star as compared to Earth. As we showed earlier, Proxima has massive solar flares, and the planets around the red dwarf must contend with them. In April 2021, an extremely powerful flare, or burst of radiation emanating from Proxima, was detected by astronomers. This flare was not only 100 times stronger than any flare seen from our Sun, but was also ranked high on being one of the most violent on a solitary star anywhere in the galaxy. Whether the flares are deadly and can lead to total annihilation remains to be seen. Moreover, it can doom chances for life on its planets. However, according to some astronomers, the verdict for life could swing either way. On one side, flares can destroy a planet's atmosphere, and on the other, they could just as well spark life. In an interesting development, scientists in 2020 detected a signal that seemed to be coming directly from the Proxima Centauri. Thus far, scientists engaged in the search for extraterrestrial intelligence, SETI, had considered the famous WOW signal, first detected in 1977, to be the most likely evidence of an alien radio signal. The detection of the new signal was unique. Although astronomers, with the help of Breakthrough Listen, the largest scientific research program aimed at finding evidence of civilizations beyond Earth, first detected the signal in April 2019, using the super powerful Parkes radio telescope at the Parkes Observatory in Australia, it was only found in the data in October 2020. The direction of the narrow beam and the apparent shift in its frequency was seen to be consistent with the movement of a planet, and excited scientists of the possible evidence of life in space. Later findings, however, claimed that the explanation for the signal was rather commonplace. The characteristics of the signal were artificial, instigating the doubt of it likely being a terrestrial source, satellites in space, or an error in general. Moreover, it was determined that only human technology produced signals like that. Our Wi-Fi, cell towers, GPS, satellite radio, all of these are very similar to the signals received, making it challenging to differentiate signals from space with that of human-generated technology. Further, for it to be certified as an alien signal, it has to go through a series of screening filters. This particular signal has excited scientists, more so because they have not had a signal jump through so many of their filters for a very long time. This signal is now being referred to as Breakthrough Listen Candidate 1, or BLC-1. Given past history, it is most likely that BLC-1 is a terrestrial signal, but scientists are continuing to study it with much interest. However, so far, they haven't been able to identify the exact source, terrestrial or otherwise. Another point of import is that the signal has come from the apparent direction of Proxima Centauri, but that does not necessarily mean that the star is the source. It could also have come from somewhere within the 16 arcminute beam width of the telescope that happened to be near Proxima Centauri, in the sky from our point of view. It also appears to be a simple signal, just a single tone, a single note. It has absolutely no additional features that we can discern at this point. The signal is drifting, as is expected, only it is doing so in the opposite direction. It should be going down in frequency, but instead the frequency is going up. Thus far, the signal hasn't been detected again, much like with the WOW signal in 1977. Another detection would help scientists determine just where it actually came from. It is very likely that the signal did not come from Proxima at all, but another source close to the star, at that time in the sky, within the beam width of the telescope. The fact that it was detected 5 times during the 30 minutes observation window over a period of 3 hours makes it interesting and a good indication that it did come from outer space. However, more work and analysis need to be done to confirm its source. BLC-1 is indeed an intriguing discovery and has given scientists and astronomers much fodder for thought. And since this unique signal has come from the direction of the star nearest us, Proxima Centauri, it is a matter that needs to be taken seriously. Will the BLC-1 signal, named WOW 2020, bring us some extraterrestrial news? What do you guys think? Drop in your comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. If you enjoyed this video and want to watch more from the world of space, please support us by becoming a superfan by clicking the link in the description. Thank you for watching. Until next time.